Hi guys, let me show you Calturin and Clone. Calturin and Clone, a game I've been working on for about half a year now. It is a 2D multiplayer co-op game, and you can also play single player if you prefer. So I'm just gonna get into it. I'm making the game in Unity, which is a free game maker you can download. And I need to host the server here. This is just on local client. And I will pick the blue mage here. And I will connect as a client and pick the red. And you can see now the red is in our game. And I'll just show you some of the game. It's still in like pre-alpha, and it's gonna take a while to add features and stuff like that. But I thought I would show it. So first of all, I hope this guy doesn't have too much health. And one thing already I need to fix is that right now when he's standing this way, I want the hit animation. I don't want him to turn around like this. So when he's standing this way, this looks fine, but I need to fix so that's his hit animation. Yeah, okay. So now it's fixed and I'm not sure why. I think I know why. So it's because when he just spawns and we haven't moved, I set his last move to something, and yeah, I can show that in code later. So I can kill him here. And the sound might play twice because I also have it open here. One cool thing I think is pretty cool that I added is that you can resurrect your ally. And I hope the sounds are not too loud. Some of the sounds might be a bit too loud. Sorry for that if they are. So, I still need to add some... I haven't added like dialogue yet or story, but I have an idea with the story, and I need to change this guy's color. But let me just quickly show you the first boss. And before actually I show you the first boss, I want to show you what I kind of like, what the prototype or the boss started out like. Actually, let's just show you the first boss fight. So you go into portal and then you meet this guy, and I also need to add some probably some sounds and some effects. And it is supposed to be like a quite challenging game, and I also need to balance it for both two players and one player. And this might look a bit easier than it looks, because I've played against this boss a lot. But let me just try to defeat him. I think I have too much health. I'm just gonna go ham because I have too much health, way too much health. I might be even a bug, so I'm not taking damage right now. But if you only have like 5 health or something, then it can be quite hard to dodge all these stuff. I need to check why I'm not losing health. Let's first of all see if I'm losing health. So player 1, that's me. Okay, so it looks like I am losing health, but for some reason it's not updating. So yeah, that's one thing you learn when you start to make a game, that there's a lot of bugs that you need to fix, and it's quite a, yeah, you think it's like, if you think it's there's some easy things about it, but things take like a lot of time. So I just want to let me show you what this fight looked like for about 4 months ago, I think. This fight looked like this. This was the prototype where you can also just shoot. You can also move and shoot. And here I also only have four life, but it was just kind of like I had, it was kind of like the first mini game I sort of made or ever like programmed as a game. I just had to kind of like make this work, which I think this might have taken me, I don't know, a month from starting to just try to make this work. But I also have something which I think is quite fun and also quite challenging, which I also showed in my trailer, which is this. I don't think I'm gonna be able to do this because this is pretty hard and also hard to focus while you do it. But I think I need to like make this a bit easier because this is pretty hard. And it also feels a bit laggy now. I think it may be because I am recording. Oh, I should not use that. Okay. I'm just gonna see how far I come. I think not, I have no idea why my health is not updating, but I need to fix that. Alright, now it's updating. Alright, that is weird. So I think I only have like two health left. I also think I need to move the camera a bit here when I do this. It's gonna be interesting. I think I need a lot of data to kind of like try to find a good mix between with the difficulty, because I wanted to be wanted to have like interesting boss fights and interesting mechanics, and then also want it to be quite difficult but also feel fair. It's also very important that this player feels like you have control of him, and his control system is nice. So one thing I'm doing with him is that when you shoot, you cannot move. So I don't want it to be just like a game where you basically just hold down like shoot key constantly and there's no like punishment for it. So here you really have to like decide, all right, when should I shoot, when should I move. And I'm really kind of like, my dream with the game is also that that some people will speed run it, because I whenever I make a boss fight, I'm always thinking, all right, I also want it to work decently as a speed run fight. So let's go into like the meat of this, or the backbone of it, or what you say. And I'm just gonna show you how the player one animator looks. So here we have the player one prefab, as it's called. And this is the animator I have right now. So basically it starts here and then it goes to idle, which is right now he's just standing still. Maybe I should do some like eye blinking or something, but I don't want him to go too crazy with idle. And then I have that he can go into player movement and then also needs to go back to idle, and also he can go from any state to being hurt and also teleport, and just have, you need to like have all these animations so that when I like click him, or if I click right, then I'm saying that, yeah, when I move right, I want these right sprites to play, and then these down sprites. And I also need to make sure that when I stand still, then it keeps on being looking that way. So for example, with my movement, if we go into here, then this is like the movement, it's called a blend tree, where depending on the position I'm walking in, I'm not sure if it will update now, but it's depending on the position. So basically if I'm walking up, then it plays this one, which should be like 0-1. So for example, player move up, then I have animation for player move one up, where I have these sprites which I can like walk through, and it should also update with the player. So for example, player move up, and you can see then I have like this sprite and this sprite, and then I have basically, so we have move up, and then you need also like, yeah, move up left, and then we have these sprites. And yeah, there's a lot of things to just like make the player move. And I'm just let's quickly go into, for example, my player movement script. So here I have player movement script, and here I have, so basically when a player spawns, I'm telling what the last move direction is, and I think this is like look to the right, and I think that was why we had the bug before, because I'm using the last move direction to tell the game which way it should play the hurt animation. And right now when you haven't moved at all, then it's just sets it to 1-0, and I think that can mess it up if you get, when you get hit, yeah, at the start. That's why you need to move, and when you move, then it looks fine. So basically, first of all, I check here an update. This is something, this all this runs, I think, 30 times a second. So this like checks 30 times a second. So first of all, I'll check if the game is over. So if the player, both players, or if the player died, basically. And if it dies, I'm just saying return. So basically, let's zoom in. Basically, don't run all this. Just go back because the player's dead. And I say if has authority, and this is like a network thing. This is so you move the player himself's move and you can't move the other. Then I start off setting like my move X and move Y value to 0.0F, which is just basically zero, and I'm actually not sure why I need to set it that. But then basically I have, if I press W, if input get key W, then I need to move Y plus one, and then so that's up, and then I also set is moving to true, which I use for other stuff. And for example, I can only shoot if is moving is false, I think. And then I also have, so if I press S, then I walk down, and if I press A, then I go minus one on move X, so I go to the left. And also, I can only do this if I'm not teleporting, so if teleport active is false, and if I'm not shooting, and if no movement is, no movement is set to false. So again, I'm actually not sure why I have this in. I need to like go over my code, and I think you need to like periodically go over your code and try to get a better idea, and also delete stuff you don't need. And in another update I also have where I basically set my move direction to and then times my move speed, so I can, for example, just close this. I can go in here and edit my player's move speed. So let's just set his player move speed to like 5 times what it was before. And I think I might need to edit that again. Let's just see here. Let's zoom out. And it should be 5 times what it was before. So he is very speedy now, and yeah, this can be useful when you're testing stuff. So the thing I'm working on, which it's inspired from Pyramid Escape, is basically you have this ball which is moving way too slowly right now, but you need to follow it. So it's basically a working memory test. And if you so let's say I go here, and then let me just zoom in. I think this is the correct one. So I have like a particle effect, and I also need to animation add that. And then if I go to the wrong one, I think, oh, it's this, then and I also need to not have that green effect. But work in progress. So I think this is pretty cool to test your working memory. All right. I had some notes, let me see. So yeah, it's in the game engine Unity, and what I focus on, one thing I can be pretty good when it comes to games is the game design, and I think I can become pretty good at coding, and then also making the story, and then I buy the art from others, or I find it for free online if there's some decent free art. But I think I spent about at least $100 so far buying, or actually much more, since I think I've spent like maybe $300 so far buying art for the game. So yeah, there's a lot of rough edges. And how long have I gone on? 15 minutes. See if there's anything. So basically, one thing that I could use some feedback on is kind of I played a lot of the Aghanim's Dota 2 stuff, and one thing, if it's like a co-op game, I want the players to. It's kind of hard because I want. It's kind of hard to like make a 5 hours co-op game or 3 hours, because usually when people play together, they play maybe like an hour. That's like a session. So one thing I'm, for example, looking at is that if I should have permadeath, so if both players die against the boss, then it's just that, or maybe they will have like three respawns, so you will have like in the Aghanim's, you have like three hearts, and then you get one more if you defeat a boss. And yeah, it's a lot of stuff I need to look at, and I guess I need to test with the difficulty. But if you have any questions to the game. Somebody asked about Tahoe bullet game, and I did not respond on that yet, but it's like there apparently there's like a genre or something where there's a lot of bullet games stuff. But right now I'm just also just trying to make the game work and not focusing too much on creating like perfect code. Also, I guess I can ask that later when it's more done. I have to like pick a good price for it. Let me just show you lastly this fight, which is almost kind of done, which is also kind of cool because you need to like shoot these, and I'm moving way too fast now. But this guy is quite difficult, and I also need to fix his hitbox and stuff. But it's quite fun to just like try to code a really difficult and interesting boss fight. But I think that was that for it. That for now. Thanks for watching and listening to me rambling. I think it's been. I started about 6 months ago, just beginning and not knowing anything about creating games. I've tried some stuff before. I tried in Dota Engine before, but I like Unity. It's been a pretty good journey. The hardest thing has been networking, but apart from that, it's been sort of smooth. And also, only way I could do networking is that I pay someone to help me code that, because that's just networking is really hard. And for your first game, like they basically recommend you make just first maybe five games and make them really simple and make them like in 1 week. So I have kind of like jump into a bigger project, but so far it's going pretty well, and I'm kind of excited about making more interesting boss fights and making more interesting mechanics, and also just having a cool co-op game where you can resurrect your ally and scream at each other and stuff like that. All right, again, if you have any questions, let me know, and thanks for watching.